Hello and welcome to Mixed Reality TV. My name is Sebastian Ang and this is the hands-on review of the Pimax 8K. So yesterday has been quite a special day for me because I went all the way to Amsterdam just to check out the world's first 8K VR headset, the Pimax 8K. There has been so much hype around that device and I simply wanted to check out what is that hype all about. Also, I was not sure should I back them on Kickstarter because there had been different kind of hands-on reviews. Some were raving about the device, but then there were also others who said like, okay, the brightness is not good enough. There are like stretching going on around the edges. There's not enough 3D binocular vision. So these kind of reviews had me hesitate because it's a $799 pledge on Kickstarter. And well, I simply had to go to Amsterdam and check it out myself and then make the decision, should I back them, yes or no. So indeed, I drove 3 hours just to see the Pimax 8K, and I suppose by now you really want to know what I thought about it. I was simply blown away by what the Pimax 8K has to offer. This is, without a doubt, the best high-end VR experience that I ever had, and as you know, I'm staring into VR goggles all day long. Now for this hands-on review, I was mostly interested in 5 things: FOV, screen door effect, stretching around the edges, brightness, and the range of the 3D binocular vision. So let's get into the in-depth review now. Let's start with the field of view. It is simply incredible. Tough to go back to what I have at home with Rift and Windows MR and so on and so forth. A total game changer. The limited FOV of VR had always been the one thing for me that was still holding me back to get fully immersed into VR. Of course, I still enjoyed all the experiences that I had until now, but the FOV of the Pimax 8K is simply such a huge difference. I was thinking of ways to make you understand just how huge of a difference it is. Have you watched those videos of colorblind people who for the first time see color when using those special goggles that allow them to see color? Now that is the difference. It is an eye-opener. Thank you, Pimax. The FOV now approaches that of normal human vision. I could still make out the edges on the right and left if I really tried hard to see it, but during gameplay I'm pretty sure you would simply be so immersed into VR that you would not see it anymore. What amazed me is that also the vertical FOV is so much improved. Looking up and down is so different now as compared to before. When before we had that feeling to look through binoculars, these binoculars have just been taken off our vision by the Pimax engineers. Now, I was wondering how could I convey how the actual FOV experience is with the Pimax 8K, and I came up with the following comparison. If the current generation is like looking through binoculars, then the Pimax 8K is like seeing the world through ski goggles. You have a fantastic view of everything around you, but you're still aware, if you look to the very edges, that you're wearing something. That comparison is also great because actually, you don't need to look for a sweet spot like you have to do in the current generation. In my hands-on time with the device, I had clear vision from edge to edge of my huge ski goggles, and that is actually pretty sweet. You simply have free view now, horizontally and vertically. This is the new industry standard once it's on the market and people have the chance to try it out. It is just tough to go back once you have seen the real deal, and that is the real deal. So now let's talk about the screen door effect. I had read a couple of people who said with the Pimax 8K there is absolutely no screen door effect, and they said they couldn't see any individual pixels anymore. So, dear people, I have to disappoint you on that one. If you really try to see the pixels, and if you really look very carefully, you can still see pixels. And if you also look carefully, you can still see the gaps between the pixels, and therefore also a very little screen door effect. But this is much better than what Vive and Rift have to offer right now, and also is still better than the Windows MR headsets. So yes, there is still a very, very little screen door effect, but when you are immersed in the world of VR, when you're playing a game, when you're doing your work, I believe you won't be able to see it anymore. It was just like, okay, I was really trying hard to see the screen door effect and to see individual pixels, And I could, and you could as well, I'm sure of that. But really, I believe when just playing, you will not see it. I was not really losing myself in the game. I was analyzing that display instead. And how often would you do that as a consumer? I asked the Pimax representative to show me big screen so I could read some more text, like on a website for example. But unfortunately, it was too time consuming for her to fire that one up because there were so many others waiting in line to try out the device. Anyways, the little text that was around in Fruit Ninja was very readable, and I believe that any productivity app would greatly benefit from being used in Pimax. Would I want to work from within the Rift? Clearly no. For Pimax 8K, that is a different story now. But for the Retina screen of VR, it seems we have to wait for the Pimax 16K and the accompanying GTX 1090 Ti. Now let's talk about the stretching around the edges. Now, that one sounded really bad when I heard other people talk about it, and actually that was one of the major things that kept me from pledging. I'm so relieved to tell you here that in my time with the Pimax 8K, I could not relate to those accounts at all. I was looking into the edges and there was no stretching going on whatsoever. I could tell, however, that somehow the lens is curved around the peripheral vision in order to cover such a big FOV, and that it does not look exactly like your real natural human vision, but I did not have the feeling that somehow content simply got stretched. Again, I really looked hard at the edges during gameplay, something that for sure I would not do during normal use. So again, when just looking around the scene like you would normally do, you would also not see that curvature in the lens that I just talked about. It just looks great. Now let's talk about brightness. And we can keep this one brief because there is absolutely no problem with brightness whatsoever. I could not tell any difference to my Oculus Rift. And I also spoke with fellow YouTuber SweeViver, who was also there. And he owns an HTC Vive, playing it all day long. And he also told me there are no difference with HTC Vive whatsoever. So now you got two accounts from an HTC Vive player and from an Oculus Rift player. And we both tell you no difference in brightness. Brightness is totally fine. Now let me talk about the range of the 3D binocular vision. I must give you my hands-on account as accurately as possible. And I simply could not make out any worse 3D vision when comparing the Pimax 8K to the Oculus Rift, the PSVR, or the Windows MR devices. I tried hard to see if the area of 3D vision was smaller than what we got used to, but I could not. I talked about that with SweeViver and he had exactly the same feeling. I personally believe that under normal circumstances, you would focus on objects that are not in your peripheral vision, but those in your central vision. And for the central vision, I had full binocular 3D, no difference to Vive or Rift whatsoever. So at the end of this hands-on review, I would like to talk about comfort. Now, this thing looks massive. It looks actually comical. And if you thought you look kind of goofy with the Vive or Rift, this one takes the cake. So with this in mind, it's actually quite surprising to find out that it's really comfortable to wear and that it is actually much lighter than I thought it would be. It is not as comfortable as the PSVR style headsets, but it's definitely as comfortable as Vive and Rift. And that is a pretty great thing to say. Yeah, that's it for my full account of my time with the Pimax 8K in Amsterdam. Needless to say, I have just backed them on Kickstarter and I'm backer number 4411. I hope you enjoyed this hands-on review of the Pimax 8K. If yes, give it a thumbs up. And I have actually so much more content coming up. I did a full review with the Pimax representative and I'm going to post it also here on Mixed Reality TV. So make sure to subscribe so you won't miss anything. But that's it for this episode. I'm very much looking forward to see you in the next video.